So first of all, I would like to say thank you to the organizing committee for giving me a chance to talk this forum, especially Professor Takahashi inviting me to this forum. I'm very happy to be here. So have you seen such ugly fish at the supermarket? Maybe no. These fish are the Japanese flounder, a kind of flat fish. These fish were infected with gram-negative bacteria, Edwardsia tardiva. This yellowtail or amberjack, this fish was infected with Nocardia cerealis. This is a gram-positive bacteria. And this is also the disease yellowtail. This yellowtail was infected and non-bacterious, but inside. So this is the livers, but the livers became a kind of the tofu. So, but you never seen like this fish. But in aquaculture place, we sometimes see such a diseased fish. So in Japan, there are, this is a very busy tables, but this is a list of authorized and commercialized vaccine in Japan. In Japan, there are several vaccines available for aquacultures. Single dose to four mixtures for target of four pathogens. But most of the, all of the vaccines based on the inactivated vaccines. And the root of the vaccination are injections. However, still, many of the infectious disease in Japan, or not only in Japan or in Asian countries, need prevention method, including the vaccines, for sustainable aquaculture. Before I start my research talk, I would like to introduce you briefly about the is fishery science important or necessary for our life? Because most of you are not fisheries persons. So this is a report from FAO. As you know, the world population grows and the food will be shortage. So population growing, the animal protein consumption per capita. This is old data, but in 1990s, the world average of the animal protein consumption per capita per day is 25 grams. But in case of developed countries, including Japan, Europe, or North America, nearly 60 grams per day. But developing countries, only 15 grams per day. At this time, mainland China or some of the Southeast Asian countries, such as Thailand, belong to developing countries. But now the many of the countries became developed countries. After the developing countries became the developed countries, their animal protein consumptions also increased. So the demand of the animal protein for food will be increased. And the FAO also reported that we need fourfold of animal protein resources compared to in 1990s. Can you imagine, or can we produce fourfold of animal proteins until year 2050s compared to 1990s? I think it's very difficult, not easy. So next, I would like to introduce you Hawaii aquaculture. So the beginning of these sessions, Dr. Takahashi introduced you about global fisheries productions. So green color indicate productions from fishing, and the orange or brown colors indicate productions from aquacultures. 2 years ago, more than half of the fisheries productions came from aquacultures. So you can easy to recognize how aquaculture is important for our animal protein source. This is a consumption of the fish and the fishery produce products in the world. In 1990s, amount of this was consumed. But please see here, from the aquacultures, in 1970s, only 0.7 kilogram per capita per year. However, 10 years ago, about 8 kilogram of the fishery product from aquacultures. So this data also indicated that how aquaculture is important. So the FAO reported that given the population growth, FAO estimated that at least an additional 50 million tons of aquatic food will be needed by year 2030 to just maintain the current per capita consumption. And this is also important. Over 90% of aquaculture production volume and over 80% of production value come from Asia. So Asia is keeping positions as an important food supplier in the world. Okay, so I would like to start my research talk. So now there are three veterinary DNA vaccines that have been commercialized in the world. One is for West Nile virus in the United States for horse, race horse. And second one is in Canada. This is for salmonid fish against IHN virus. This is a rhabdovirus, single-strand RNA virus. And the third one is, this is not for infectious disease. This is for treatment of cancer disease of dog in United States. Only three DNA vaccines are available, commercialized. But last year in Europe, European medicines agencies authorized DNA vaccines for using salmon against one virus, it's RNA virus. So the internet news said a new era of the DNA vaccine for salmon farming are coming. Okay, I think some of you know well about the DNA vaccine, but some of you not much know about DNA vaccine. So I'd like to briefly, very briefly, introduce you about vaccines. This is a case of the virus. This is a vaccine, the plasmid. In case of the virus, when infected the host cells, the virus transcribe its genes and translate its proteins and make a copy of the virus. But the immune system, T cells recognize molecules or proteins which are expressed from the virus. In case of the DNA vaccine, when we inject the plasmid DNA, this plasmid DNA go into the cells and the genes which is encoded by this plasmid will be transcribed and translated. And then the foreign proteins will be recognized by CD8 killer T cell or CD4 helper T cell to stimulate the cytotoxic adaptive immune system or activation of the B cell to produce a specific antibody against a protein which is encoding by this plasmid. And a good point of DNA vaccines, you can put several antigens from different pathogens in one plasmid. Then you can culture just E. coli for making enough plasmid DNA. But in case of the several combination vaccines at present, as I told you, in Japan, there are four combination vaccines. But in the case, the companies should 가르쳐 four different pathogens separately. Then, after inactivated, they combine. So the combination vaccines based on the inactivations of pathogens, it makes a lot of cost. So the price increased. So the good point of DNA vaccines can combine many of the pathogens, antigens in one plasmid. So I would like to introduce you about my research for development of DNA vaccines against several fish pathogens. The first I'd like to introduce you about RNA virus, Hirame rhabdovirus. This is belong to Novi rhabdovirus. And this plasmid is RNA single strand, negative single strand RNA virus. And this virus is a simple virus. This virus has just five genes. And in these studies, we used glycoprotein genes. Glycoproteins exist on the surface of virus. And I also use nucleocapsid proteins. This protein is exist in inside of virus. So we cloned the two genes and then constructed the recombinant plasmid. And in this study, we use IMPT vector as a negative control and the PBS also as a negative control. Then we inject DNA or PBS to the fish. And after a month, we conducted the challenge test. So in case of control groups and N-gene DNA vaccinated fish, after 1 week, all fish died. But in case of G-gene DNA vaccinated fish, the mortality was only 10%. So the mortalities were significantly different, G-DNA vaccinated group fish and others. So this table shows relative percent survivors. Relative percent survival is important for evaluation of the vaccines in aquacultures. In general, over 60% of RPS is good vaccines. The, in case of the G-genes DNA vaccines, RPS is over 60. And we also studying why G-gene DNA vaccine gave a good protection to fish, and why N-gene DNA vaccinated fish doesn't give a good protection to fish. So we are using the microarray or NGS or several molecular biological techniques to evaluate the good vaccine and not good vaccines. But anyway, today, due to the time limitations, I didn't show you, but we are also doing such studies. Next, I'm going to talk about DNA virus. In this study, we use koi herpes virus. Koi herpes virus infection first reported in Israel and USA in 1990s. After that, this KHV infection spread over the world because fancy cup competitions in the world. So the people who are involved in fancy cup competitions, people bring their nice fancy cup to many countries. And before outbreak of KHV infection in koi cup, usually the koi carp competition, they put many of the carp in one tanks. So if there was one infected fish, that infected koi carp give this virus to other koi carp in one tanks. So this KHV infection quickly spread in the world. And the mortality of this KHV infection is very high, nearly 100%. So we conducted a genome analysis of KHV isolated from Japan, United States, and Israel, and compared. And we found about 140 genes from KHV. So for development of a DNA vaccine against this virus, we have to choose some protective genes for vaccinations from these 180s. So we targeted membrane proteins and glycoproteins, and that glycoproteins which exist might be on the surface of virus. So in case of the KHV, we found five a kind of the membrane proteins and five of glycoprotein genes. So the first trials, we mix these five kind of the membrane protein genes, and in case of the G glycoprotein, we mix the five G proteins for vaccination and challenge test. This is our control groups. After 3 weeks, the mortalities become over 50%. The control group, we injected empty vectors. And in case of the five mixture of the DNA vaccine of the transmembrane, or a five mixture of glycoprotein genes from KHV, gave us some protection to CARP. So we thought that there are some good protective genes in these five. So the second trials, we use each genes separately for vaccinations and conducted the challenge test. But unfortunately, membrane proteins, no significant protections. However, some show some difference to the control group. The, in case of the glycoprotein, also no good protection in single use of them. However, some show some difference to control group. Then we conducted the third trial of the vaccinations for combinations with the different genes. Like this, and like this. And fortunately, a mixture of transmembrane gene 1, 3, and glycoprotein 2, three mixtures, gave a good protection to COI CARP. But the combinations, just a T1, T3, or a single use of G2, no protection. But we don't know why these three mixtures gave a good protection to COI CARP. We need more studies about immune reactions of CARP after vaccination of these DNA vaccines. So next, I'm switch to talk about bacterial DNA vaccine development. The first trial is Nocardia cereulae. This is a kind of the intracellular pathogens. So treatment is not easy because this bacteria can survive in the inside of the host cells. So antibiotic treatment doesn't work very well compared to other fish pathogenic bacteria. So we need to develop vaccines. And this Nocardia species show another, in case of the fish pathogen, the species name is Nocardia cereulae, but other pathogen, Nocardia asteroides, not the fish pathogen, but show the cross antigenicity with mycobacterium, such as Mycobacterium tuberculosis, this is the human pathogen, and also Mycobacterium bovis. This is one of the live attenuated vaccines for prevention of this disease in mammals. And in case of the Mycobacterium, there are many studies about development of the vaccines. So this is one of the vaccine candidate, antigen 85. So in case of the Nocardia cellulare DNA vaccine development, we target this gene. So first we clone these genes from Nocardia cellulare and then make plasmid DNAs for DNA vaccinations. So this is a trial, DNA vaccination trials of using the Japanese Flanders. So the, in case of the control groups, after a month, 100% died. However, in case of DNA vaccinated fish groups, mortality is not very low, but lower than to control groups. When we use AmbaJAX, after about 1 month, the mortality in the control groups was 69%. However, DNA vaccinated groups, the mortality is significantly lower. This. So, however, so DNA, in case of this bacterial disease, DNA vaccines gave some protections to fish, however, not very good protection. So next, we use another bacterial species, Photobacterium damusella subspecies piscicida. These are bacteria infect several marine fish species. So this bacterial infection is one of the most serious infectious disease in Japan marine aquaculture. And in case of these pathogens, before the name was Passera piscicida, but this name was changed to the Photobacterium damusella subspecies piscicida based on the genes, on the molecular analysis. And several years ago, we identified the major antigenic protein of these bacteria. Of course, all the major antigenic genes not be protective antigens, but in this study, we use these three major antigenic protein genes for DNA vaccination trials. One is the lipoprotein, one is the serine protease, and one is the outer membrane proteins. Then conducted a DNA vaccination test. You can see all the three DNA vaccines gave protection to fish. And it's a significant protection compared to the control groups. However, the mortality was around 30%. So the protection of these three DNA vaccines were about 65% to 80%. So the protection was good, but not very good compared to the studies in virus DNA vaccines. So we thought that something we have to modify. Then we thought maybe the codon usage are important. Because in case of the virus use the host transcription and the translation systems. But in case of the bacteria has its own transcription and translation system. So most of the bacterial codon usage are different to that of host. So in case of this, we compare the codon usage of fish and some fish bacterial pathogens. For in case of arginines, one of the bacteria mainly use CGC. However, in case of the fish, mainly use AGA or AGG. Like this, so the codon usage in some amino acid residues are different between the host and bacteria. So we optimize the codon usage of the DNA vaccine of them to codon usage of fish. Then we conducted a DNA vaccination test. So the protection of the D3 DNA vaccine over 80%. So it became nice. So then next we target, we focus one DNA vaccines and to study for understanding why the cordon optimization gave a better protection to fish. So the vaccine efficacy, the bacterial growth, specific antibody productions, and some of the gene expressions after vaccinations. As I showed you, the cordon optimization gave a good protections, better protections. And in case of the bacteria, after challenge, in case of the control groups, in the kidneys, bacteria grows rapidly. But in case of the vaccinated fish, not grows. And formerly inactivated vaccine, the wild-type adeno vaccine, the cordon optimized ones, not significant differences. And in case of the specific antibodies, this is a wild type of the DNA vaccines. In case of the wild type of the DNA vaccinated fish, not much produce specific antibodies against the pathogens. However, in case of the codon usage or optimized DNA vaccines, at the 30 days of the vaccinations, fish produce specific antibodies significantly to these pathogens. Next, we studied gene expressions of some inflammatory-related cytokines, IL-1, TNF, interferon gamma, or interleukin-6. So you can see the, all the cytokine gene expressions. Codon-optimized groups higher expression of these cytokines compared to the wild type of DNA vaccinated fish. So that these results indicated that in case of the bacterial DNA vaccines, codon optimizations will give a good protections to fish. So the DNA vaccine will help sustainable aquaculture from several microbial infectious diseases, I believe. Thank you for your kind attentions.